My name is David Irwin, and I'm a product manager at Tanium. And I want to talk to you about an exciting new feature in Tanium Comply called Remote Authenticated Scanning, or RAS. Now, to show what RAS is, let's take a look at this findings page here. So I'm looking at compliance results in our demo environment. And if I group by operating system and scroll down here, you'll see this Cisco in here. You may, if you're familiar with Tanium, you may be surprised to see Cisco in here because you think, hey, you can't put the Tanium client on networking devices. How did you do this compliance scan? And the answer is remote authenticated scanning. So what RAS is a new feature. It takes advantage of a new feature of Tanium called Satellite to target compliance and vulnerability scans at parts of your network that have no Tanium clients, at unmanaged devices. So Tanium Satellite is a feature where you can promote any Tanium client to a satellite so that you can do things like scan remote networks where there are no Tanium clients, or you can securely handle credentials or large volumes of data. So RAS is built on top of Satellite, again, to target these remote networks really for two main reasons. And the first is it lets you broaden the coverage of your networks. You can now reach subnets where you otherwise have no other Tanium clients because you haven't yet deployed clients there, or maybe you can't. And the second advantage of RAS is it lets you target endpoints that can't support a Tanium client, like that network devices we talked about. So networking devices, hypervisors, maybe old versions of operating systems that can no longer support the modern Tanium client. So it's obviously a very exciting feature, again, to help you cover your network. Let's look a little bit about how you set this up. So the first thing I want to do is go create some credentials, because like I mentioned, these are authenticated scans. So if I go into here and create some new credentials, you have a choice in here of Windows or non-Windows credentials. So for Windows, you pick a username password. For non-Windows, you can set up an SSH key. You can also still use username password. You could do pseudo escalation and a number of other options for your credentials. And it's very important to create the credentials based off of the kind of things you're going to be scanning. You want to target things appropriately. So once you have your credentials, you go into assessments and I'll create a new one. I'm going to choose compliance, although it's really the same pattern for vulnerability. So I'm just going to give it a fake name here. I'm not going to actually save it. But the new option here is here, scan method. So client base is what we've always had before, where the Tanium client runs on the endpoint it's scanning. But now we have remote authenticated. So when I choose this, I now get a list of satellites to choose from. And again, this is the satellite where my scan is going to run from. And what's cool about this is, by the way, it's going to use the same Tanium client. So you get the same quality of data you get for client-based scans, but of remote-based, remote unmanaged devices. So if I choose this first satellite in our environment here, and now I'm just going to preview and see, like, what is the satellite already found that I'm going to be able to scan? You can see a number of endpoints down here, some VMware devices, some Cisco. You can also add targeting if you want to limit your scans. Let's say I just want to scan my Cisco devices. I can choose this here, apply that, update my preview, and now I've got the Cisco device I want to scan down here. Again, our demo environment is somewhat limited. And then you choose the credentials. And again, you want to make sure you pick credentials that match the things you're going to be scanning so that you can log into those things. And that's basically it. Actually, the one thing I want to show you as well is we do have some Cisco benchmarks. This is new. So I'm going to choose just an iOS benchmark here, pick a profile. And after that, basically, it's no different than any other assessment. You choose the schedule that you want to do. And then when you create it, it's going to go out in the endpoints and start scanning. So let me show you a bit more about the results we got here. So we looked a minute before at the compliance results, but you can actually go look at all of them by just choosing your scan method, remote authenticated. And again, my Cisco results are here, and same thing with vulnerability. So I can go into here and filter to just show me the results from remote authenticated scans. And there we go. You'll see we have a bunch of CVEs. These are mostly being found by VMware. So we, out of the box with this new version of RAS, we support Cisco devices, iOS, iOS XE, ASA, as well as VMware ESX and ESXi. We have more to come. We're going to be adding other networking devices such as Juniper and Palo Alto. And like I mentioned, you also will have support for older versions of operating systems that no longer support the Tanium client. Like for example, Windows Server 2008, non-R2, or even Windows XP. So that's basically it. This is a very exciting new feature. Again, the whole point of it is it helps you broaden the coverage of your network. So now you can bring more and more of the things you own under compliance and vulnerability scans. So if there's anything else you want to see about this, please reach out to your account team and they'll coordinate with me or some of our SMEs. We can set up a demo or get this installed in your environment. And if you have any feedback, I'd love to hear it. And that's it. Thank you very much. Have a good day.